I think in that chamber you can produce enough energy to run your house for about 20, 30 years.
Right, sounds good.
Yeah. And then you calibrate your reactor core that this position gives me protein level. This level gives me copper core. And then when you can tap into it, when you extract it, it gives you different material. Material production in the universe is that way. Material production in the universe is that way. So if you get the you got the sun in the center, that's your middle core which you just turned on. As you go further away from the core, the strength reduces. When the strength reduces, then becomes weak enough that it becomes matter, and then you different type of matter. And depends where you are in this matter, you get liquid, you call it Earth. You get a harder, you get the Mercury, and then you get a Jupiter. And because of their position and the gravitational field, they position themselves and they absorb that material in there. So you become a sponge for that material. You understand? This is what we call, you can create the gravitational magnetic field of any element. So you don't need different reactors. You have the way you showed there, the way your plasma moves, the way you touch your finger and you see the field come together. You understand? Once you have energy of one matter, then you convert that energy, which is a magnetic field in motion, into a gas and a GANS. And then there is a process to convert the GANS into matter. You understand?
Yes.
So basically, just to try to understand that, let's say Rick got a 5 meters pipe. In the first meter of the pipe, when glows, you will get one matter. In the second meter of the pipe,
if you create the right condition, yes.
Yeah, okay, yeah, that makes sense.
It's like condensing out the materials from a higher energy level.
You see, the misunderstanding in the world of science, a lot of it comes from biology. Yeah? The man never understood the biology of his own body, and he's taken the same mistake into the universal condition. So, if you understand this, that's why I say you treat the body like a galaxy, then you understand what everything is in the galaxy. In the galaxy, you have all the matters of the universe. So the condition is created to create that matter in that position. You have to understand how that condition is created. You create a condition which only gives you protein in the pipe. You can create a condition in the pipe where you only produce gold, because you need gold. You produce a condition which all the fields come to the strength of, let's say aluminium. You don't need to take aluminium from Earth or do a conversion. Conversion of a matter is the habit of man. Universe converts as it needs. You have to understand what the need and the position is. In certain gravitational fields, aluminium cannot exist and hold the way it performs on Earth. You have to find a matter which holds and performs as aluminium the way you want it. Aluminium, most probably in other surfaces in the universe, just becomes evaporated or becomes so solid you can't even cut it. It's a conditional, environmental conditional dependence. It's the same as what you did in that tube. As you change the vacuum, different plasma conditions showed itself. This is what we as humans always related our science to our own body, and we never understood it fully, so the mistake has piled up.
Well, I found it quite interesting. I was doing the work to translate your one of your latest videos to the English, to write the English out. And you were talking about our bodies having radioactive substances in them, and that they're there for a very definite purpose, and that is having to do with this cutting action between the cells and so on. And I thought that was a really good idea that you brought up there, and something that I hadn't really considered before.
The thing is, in the universe, there is a cutting mechanism. The cutting mechanism comes very simply at one higher level. Yeah? You want to cut in the matter world, you want to cut a bread, you can cut it with a piece of a string. You want to cut a bone, or you want to cut a meat, use a knife. You want to cut a bone, you use a rotating steel. Yeah? When we want to cut diamond, we use diamond, which is in different shape. Yeah? So, the same principle applies in the universe. You use radiation because the thinner they can cut through. The thinner the deviation or division comes through a lighter radioactive material, and stronger, like bones and heavier material, it goes through the heavier. Cesium, we use it. And it's the same process in the body. You use B12, you use B6, you use B9.
So you have to create a condition in your pipe for what material you want to produce. In reality, you dictate in Tehran in 2008, I knew I'm going to produce protein. But the effectiveness which was produced, in a way, puzzled me how easy it was to produce it on a continuous basis. Mm. Because then I realized you created condition of a blood vessel. The blood vessel, the structure of the blood vessel is a converter of energy into matter. This is why no iron crosses the blood and it goes and finds itself in the cell. The energy of iron, magnetic gravitational field of an iron package, transfers through the blood vessel, and then it reduces, it changes the gas into matter and it becomes gas. This is exactly how we produce CO2 as a solid state. So you produce the same thing through transition of walls, different strength. And this is what in book number 5, I explained this very, very thoroughly. And even in the presentation of in the center a few months ago, where we speak about lung and blood, I explained this, soon we're going to release a video of it. I explained how no oxygen ever crosses the wall of the lung. This is a myth. This is like saying the Earth was the center of the universe. No oxygen ever crosses the boundary and the lining of the lung. All it happens is, it's in the video and it's in the book coming out. All it happens, that's why you get a CO2. You breathe in oxygen through the same thing as you're doing in that tube, and the material which is within the lung, you take only oxygen is 16, carbon is 12. You only take a helium factor out energy level. And that energy transfers across the boundary of the wall of the lung into the blood. And no oxygen goes into the blood. All it does, this energy energizes the blood, red, what we call red blood cells, and they become brighter, exactly like the way you do the light toning. You increase the energy, the light becomes brighter. This is a misconception and total misunderstanding of all the medicine. There is no oxygen crossing your lung. And then what happens? Because you take a factor of 4 out of the helium out of the oxygen, what are you left with carbon? The carbon binds with 2 oxygen, which is coming in, you breathe out CO2, because that's the stability of the magnetic field of the package. So No oxygen ever goes through the wall, because this is nonsense. The molecule, the atom of oxygen is so big. When you breathe in, you breathe carbon, you breathe nitrogen, you breathe hydrogen, you breathe anything else like the elements. So if a molecule
or an atom of hydrogen is supposed to cross the wall of the lung, all those lighter gases are smaller, they go through too.
Right.
So we don't see that. Our body has, in our blood, has a specific gravitational magnetic field for helium.
Right, yeah? See.
And it extracts that much energy out of the pack. It's just like you bring a pot of water, you bring a bowl of water, and you just take a cup out of it, what you need, not the whole lot. And this is another misconception. And if you understand this and then convert it into your pipe with shine, then you understand how you can create different matters in the space. You don't need to take anything with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, otherwise we should have more nitrogen in our blood than anything else, because the air is 3/4 nitrogen, right?
Yes, but what is that nitrogen? What's the atomic number of nitrogen?
I think it's... is it 14?
What's the atomic number of oxygen?
Be 16, correct?
So how can the smaller one get this top? And even go for a carbon, go for a hydrogen. Yeah? Even if you go for a molecule of hydrogen, which is in the air we breathe, that should be able to get through the wall of the lung very easier than the hydrogen,
yes,
than the oxygen. So no oxygen ever crosses the wall of the lung. No element ever crosses the wall of the blood vessels. Is the conversion packages, the minute we open the blood and we test it, the conversion comes. That's why it's always there's a calcium in the blood, there is a blah blah in the blood, or there is a zinc in the blood.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a balloon of a plasma equal to copper. When you open the blood, the minute it comes to the atmosphere touch, it changes to matter. You understand? So if you go into the blood vessel, we don't see any red blood. It's colorless. The minute it comes in touch with the body, with the air, we see the color of red. So if you have a different composition, when your blood comes in touch with the air, it becomes blue, yellow, whatever, or green. This one you understand? This is causing a lot of thinking about what I'm writing now. Why we have different blood colors? Why should we green or blue? We have animals which have a blue blood in the sea. And it's used by FDA for faster testing of the new pharmaceutical products. Yeah? There's I can't remember his name. It's got a blue blood, so FDA now speeds up the testing time for new medicine using this animal. It's a fish. It's like a... I can't remember his name. So, because different material, because that blood has copper in it, it's blue.
Oh, yeah.
Ours has iron in it. We are red when it comes into interaction with the air. So when we see other creatures in the world, in the universe, which have a different composition, like potassium or calcium or whatever else, we see them different color blood. That doesn't mean anything. But the other thing interesting is, would we be able to interact and produce offspring of each other? Because red one is the stronger, can destroy the other one. So most probably we can never have children with aliens, huh? Or not with some of them, because their blood is different than ours. You understand?
Yeah.
These are the things you see when you run your reactors. These are the things you should watch. When you see a glow on your pipe the way you did, try to analyze it outside the box in reality. Not the way we've been forced to understand. Understand the behavior of the plasma, understand the behavior of the universe, they're all the same in different scales.